So Alabama did a good job of protecting their home court. One thing I talked to our guys about
when we started, I said, the team that's hungry is going to find a way to win this game. So they're a very hungry team. So they have talented young guys. Some of them haven't played a lot, but they're very talented. I said, they'll come out ready to fight. They'll scratch and claw to try to find a way to get a win. They did just that. They competed from start to finish, and they found a way to win. They did a great job, especially in the second half, getting steals and turning us over in the press.
Because you just talk about the steals, the ball handling. I think they had 15 today, 14 or 15, and 10 in the second half, I noticed.
And it was 7, well, we ended up with 17 turns. I think for us, it's, some of those are careless. You have to give those guys credit for really getting out of the passing lane, being assertive. I thought we were hesitant in making passes and making plays and moves, but have to give those guys credit for that. They're very active.
In that moment, when it was, we were only trailing 34-33, and then the 8 turnovers over the next 7 minutes, that their attack on defense and the lack of response from your guys being settled, what'd you see in there?
I think once again, they did a good job of really being assertive and impressed. They're getting their hands on the ball and they got some steals. And I think on our end, you know, not making shots from the 3-point line. So I thought we had some open looks and those shots not falling down. So now you get a little hesitant on the perimeter.
Can you talk about not playing Jordan after the second foul in the first half? Is that kind of your hard and fast rule if a guy picks up two?
It is. I mean, just from a standpoint, you don't want him to get another foul, especially where the game is flowing. Don't want him to get his third foul. No, I'd rather sit a guy down if he gets two in the first half.
Will you adjust that depending on if it's a senior as opposed to a freshman?
In this case, there's just a young guy letting him get a feel for it. Don't want him to get the third foul. But I think as you go, as a guy gets older, you get a feel for a situation. You understand who you have, and then you kind of go from it. But I think in this case, it was safe just sitting down the first half.
So you obviously prepared for their different varieties of defense, but you know, when you see it in person, is it even better, quicker, you know, more?
I think they did a good job. I thought we were, you know, we didn't make a couple crisp passes. I thought we were a little hesitant on our passes. I thought we received the ball in some situation. We didn't attack like we need to as far as attacking the rim. And they got their head up and they made some plays. But I thought we had some careless turnovers there, especially in that stretch. So I think they got like 3 or 4 turnovers.
With the, in terms of actually replicating what they do, you know, if you're a matchup zone from South Carolina or anything, going into the game, I mean, how much do you actually try to go against that pressure and things like that?
Oh, we go through different. We have what we call a blue team that kind of go against it. I just think in our case, we didn't do a good job of moving the ball, you know, passing the ball through there and then attacking. I thought we were careless with our pass and kind of let the press come to us. Then we try to make a pass.
Rebounds, Coach, you think that kind of reflection of Kenny, even if you think that's where it showed up, his absence, the offensive blast, especially with the Alabama was able to do?
I think so, but I mean, because, you know, you're going through situations like he's familiar with what's going on with our zone offense and things like that. He's very familiar. You know, he probably doesn't score a lot and he knows the cuts and movements of it, but also box out rebound. But I wouldn't necessarily say that was the case because they got a lot of long rebounds, guard rebounds, and they're a good guard rebounding team.
So after the last game, I think you said that y'all came down here, you'd be surprised if you had like a 20 turnover game or came out here.
Yes.
And just did something like that. And then that's almost what it was today. How much that surprised you?
I just thought it's the surprising part was I thought we would look careless with our passes and not crisp and not attacking up the court and being aggressive. But I thought when our perimeter guys weren't making shots from the 3-point line, then there was a level of hesitancy as opposed to continuing to attack and making those shots. And your shot and falling, at least attack the rim. I thought that was the case more than anything.
Even some of the guys have talked about having confidence coming off of the Florida game. When you miss a couple of shots early, do you think, you know, mentally some of your guys were thinking back to some of the other road struggles earlier in the year?
I don't think so. I mean, I thought we had some good looks. I don't think they think about that. Just as a player, you're making shots, you're missing shots. I think you're playing in the game. I think more than anything, you think about the last turnover you had or the last shot you missed, not necessarily, you know, 5 games out of the road where you lost a road game. I just think you're looking at the shot that you missed and was it a good shot or a bad shot.
Even in the 5 previous SEC losses, I don't think you'd say you really got out-hustled or out-worked or anything like that, but did Alabama have kind of a level of intensity that you didn't match there for certain stretches?
I think so. I really do. I thought they were hungry trying to get a win. Had some talented young guys. Played a lot of Minnesota's guys. They were aggressive. They were assertive. They wanted to win that game.